Hi, this is Kel from Alpha Beta Aeronautics. Thank you for choosing us as a platform to expand your knowledge into quantitative finance and econometrics. In one of our previous learning materials, we talked about how R still stores data. And here, we're going to talk about how we can handle this data and perform some statistical operations. This is done by functions. This video and the learning material is dedicated on expanding your knowledge about functions, how they're created, where they can be found, and how they can be used to perform complex statistical operations. So, let's go to R.
In R, data analysis is performed by using functions and applying them onto objects or data sets. Each function in R has its own syntax, and in this learning material, I will show you where you can find readily available functions and also how to create your own custom functions. Now, in the base version of R that you installed on your computer, there are several functions that are embedded and can help you begin your data analysis. However, for more complex models, you need to access functions that are in so-called packages that are installed additionally into your R platform. To install a package, you need to use the function install packages. In this case, I will install the package quantmod, which is one of the most widely used packages in investment management. And now the platform, when connected to internet, starts to download the package and all other packages that are actually related to this one. Once it is downloaded and installed, the package is in your laptop. To load it into your current R window, you need the function require. And then this package, the functions from this package are readily available to use in the current environment. Now, this is the biggest advantage of RStudio in front of other available softwares. Because you have access to unlimited number of packages, and it is safe to say that you can download and use functions for every mathematical or econometric model. So basically, you don't have to create your own functions, you don't have to be a specialist in mathematics, you just have to install them and use the functions that are in these packages. In order to update a package, you can use the function update packages. But in parentheses, it is good to apply this function to your most widely used packages from time to time in order to keep up with the updates that other specialists put into these packages. So, still, if you're not satisfied with the functions that are presented in the online available packages, you can create your own function in R, because this is a open source software. So, let's try and create our own custom function. First, we have to name it. And then we use function, and the first thing that we need to input are the variables that the function will use, in this case x and y. And now we input curly brackets where R expects to find the body of the function. In this case, I will just make up some kind of combination between those two variables. And then by closing the curly brackets, we're ready with the function. So, I can input my function. And you see R expects me to put values on x and y. Let's say 4 and y is equal to 5. And then the function is executed and it prints out the result. Of course, this is a very simple function, but you can grasp the basics and perhaps create your own more sophisticated functions. Also, it is very helpful to plot your function in order to see graphically how it looks. First, I will set up a sequence of numbers for the two variables x and y. And then by plotting the function, we get how it is calculated using the different combinations of x and y. Now, to make it more clear, let's make a case study. Let's say we have this task in front of us. We have to create a function in R that helps users estimate the expected salary for an employee in a given company. The parameters are as follows. Each employee has a base salary of $1,000. The experience is priced by multiplying 1.5% for the natural logarithm of years of experience, and then whatever we get, we multiply by the base of $1,000. Also, the salary depends on the category of skills that is determined by the HR department on the grades from 1 to 5. And moving each level up, we increase the salary of $250. For example, the lowest level 0 has $0 added to the salary, and the highest level 5 has $1,255. Finally, we also have to add the inflation protection, which is calculated by multiplying the base salary and the skills premium that we get by the chosen inflation factor. So, what we have to do first is to create a function that calculates the salary. Next, make an example what will be the salary of person X with 8 years of experience, which have a skill grade of 3, and also we assume the expected inflation of 2.5%. And the final task is to plot the function in respect to the experience variable while using grade level 4 and also assume inflation factor of 2%. So let's begin. Now I'm going to create my function. I will call it salary. And first I have to input the variables. We have the base, which is $1,000 in this case, but we'll make it a variable so we can change in the future. The experience variable I will call XP. Also, I have a variable for the grade and also the inflation factor. Now I put the curly brackets, and here I'm gonna input the function that will estimate the salary. So, from what we know, the estimation of salary starts with the base. We have to estimate the premium for the experience. This is done by multiplying 1.5% by the logarithm of years of experience, which will come from the XP variable, and then this premium is multiplied by the base. Next, the grade variable will be multiplied by 250, which is the premium for each category. And finally, the inflation factor will be multiplied by the base plus the grade by 250. I will close the curly brackets and my function is ready to be used. Now, the second task is to make an example with a person X that has certain experience, certain grade level, and also we have assumption about the inflation factor. So I tap my function. As a base, we set there's at $1,000. The experience is 8 years. The grade, I think, was 3. And also the inflation factor was equal to 0.024. The function estimates that this person will receive 1,000 $823, where this is useful if you're in an HR department in some company and you have such a way for determining salaries, then you can easily tell the future employee how much will be their salary. Now the final task is to plot this function in respect to the experience variable, given some constants for the other parameters. So first I will create a sequence for the XP for the experience variable, which will be numbers from 0 to 40. 0 will be a person who starts now and doesn't have any years of experience, and 40 will be a person which will have 40 years of experience. So basically in this sequence we have covered almost any options for getting a new guy into your workplace. And now I will plot the function salary, given that the base will be 1000, the XP will be the sequence of XP. Grade will equal to 4 and the inflation factor is 0.02. So here we have plotted the function. The function, what will be the salary of a person based on their experience from 0 to 40 years. Actually, this is very helpful to management because this will tell you what kind of a person you're looking for based on this, on the budget that you have. So you see, using the custom creation of functions, you can extend the capabilities so far outside the econometric models and mathematics. And actually you can use it to make your work more efficient, whatever you're doing.